Welcome to another Health News video news release brought to you by Health News. In today's news, we look at several ways you can balance your blood sugar. With diabetes affecting 371 people worldwide, maintaining healthy blood sugar should be at the top of everyone's health priority list. Recent studies show your digestive tract, gut microbiome, may be a key area to explore to lower your blood sugar. One study found that a group given a probiotic-rich shake for 30 days showed a significant balancing of sugar levels. While the placebo group, who received a shake without the beneficial microbes, showed no change at all. Here is how to improve your gut microbiome. Eat the right foods. Eating a lot of leafy green vegetables will help plant your gut with healthy and diverse bacteria. Include fermented foods in your diet. Eat sauerkraut, pickles, kimchi, kefir, yogurt, not processed, and kombucha. These foods are rich in prebiotics. Remove the sugar and processed foods from your diet. A diet high in processed foods and added sugar can decrease the amount of good bacteria in your gut. Sweat every day. Research shows that exercise actually increases the good bacteria in your gut. Get enough sleep. Sleep deprivation has been associated with obesity due to causing significant changes in your gut flora. Get in a relaxed state. Since your gut is your second brain, one of the most important factors to healing your gut is your own consciousness. The key is to keep supporting your microbiome and keeping your blood sugar levels in check with a healthy lifestyle. Remember, your best source for everything health is your chiropractor. Visit your chiropractor regularly and make sure your nervous system is functioning 100%. Also, if you are watching this video on Facebook, please love our page, comment, and share. If you are watching this video on our YouTube channel, please subscribe. And if you are watching this video on our website, and if not already done so, please add your name and email address to the form on this page. And that's it for today's health news.